Bandwidth limitations and noise have a considerable impact on the quality of data being transmitted. In many cases, the quality requirement and the volume of data being downloaded is now greater than some systems can handle. With lower bandwidth systems like wireless networks, there are limits on how much data can be successfully sent at any given moment. Bandwidth-sensitive services such as VoIP and video on demand, the central network technology has been configured to ensure that these services have priority over any email or chat traffic. This means that sensitive traffic will always be sent, ensuring no delays or loss in transmission. Less sensitive traffic may be stored or queued until there is an ideal opportunity to send this data. This happens in terms of a microseconds on a network device, so that the user will notice this happening when chatting using Facebook or watching a video across a network. Noise is any external or internal interference that has the effect on the quality of the data being sent. External noise can be caused by electrical equipment or local physical features. Internal noise is often caused by poor quality cabling or connections. Wireless networks rely on high frequency radio transmissions, which are normally limited to no more than 100 meters. Noise can be caused by metal frame buildings causing reflection and acting like a Faraday cage, as well as any powerful unshielded electrical. Wireless networks tend to suffer from external interference. Copper cabling, as used for most data networks, is limited to a range of 100 meters for data networks. This is very susceptible to noise from external power sources, even something as simple as a power cable run. Also, with the electro-magnetic nature of the cable and the fact that many cables are run together, the cables have to be twisted to reduce the internal noise, called crosstalk, and the terminals have to be terminated professionally to improve the quality of communication. Otherwise, internal reflection and crosstalk can occur, which adds to the noise. In practice, both unshielded and shielded twisted pair cables are used. Fibre optic networks are self-contained methods of transmitting data using light. Except on low quality connections, there is a small chance of internal interference and no risk of internal interference. The transmission of data is also reliant on the channel type, that is the medium used to transmit the data across considerable distances. Wireless, fibre and copper have distance limitations. The following communication channels are frequently used. Telephone links, often referred to as POTS, pretty old telephone system. These are still used in developing nations and remote parts of the UK, as well as a backup method for accessing core networking equipment in case of a primary communication failure. Microwave, transmissions sent by Bluetooth and wireless networks are defined as microwave as they operate on the 2.4 GHz band of the electromagnetic spectrum. High-powered microwave transmission is still used in the line-of-sight communications for high-speed network communications in large cities. Radio transmission. At higher frequencies, radio transmission is used by a wide range of services to exchange data. Services such as police, ambulance, and fire use radio transmission to communicate crucial information. Satellites have been used as a method for high-speed data transmission between countries for some considerable time. The facility is becoming more accessible to the individual user and small business as costs drop. Satellite transmission is relying on atmosphere conditions as well as light of sight communication with the satellite. However, communication with a satellite in a geostationary orbit can increase the distance around the globe that the network can reach. ADSL, asymmetrical digital subscriber services. These services are an extension of the type of technology used in a network at work or college. ADSL and broadband use an unbalanced bandwidth to provide performance. You may be able to download at 2 megabits per second, but your upload speed is likely to be 1/10 of this. ADSL accesses unused bandwidth on telecommunication systems and is limited to a 2 km reach from the telephone company relay. New ADSL technologies are extending this range. Data compression is required on low bandwidth services to improve the rate of data transmission. Compression of applications, games, images, videos, and audio still takes place. For example, a JPEG image is a compressed format. There are many formats used on different systems. A common format used in data transmission and compression of files is the Huffman coding. Huffman coding applies a binary sequence to characters, letters of the alphabet, digits and symbols, according on how often they are used. Therefore, if a letter is used more than others, it is given a small sequence. If the letter is uncommon, it is given a longer sequence. Huffman coding thus allows data compression in the transmission and information from one system to another. Huffman coding required in the use of processor resources for the sending and receiving devices.